A discussion between three people. Good evening. Come in. Thank you for coming. I'm sorry my request came so late in the day, but I hope you know you can sleep here tonight after we talk, both of you and your two men, too. Please. Thank you, my sister. You are welcome, Nikos. And you, Praetor, are your men comfortable where they are? Yes, Holy Mother. I can only be grateful for your enlightenment and hospitality. Thank you. Thank you, Sir Timaeus, for those kind words. You know, some people are not happy with the way you protect this old man who might take away their precious lands and houses. Pinot Grigio from Italy. Not very expensive. After the usual supermarket discount, I pay about $7 for this bottle, which is not cheap, but not expensive. It's a low price, but not cheap. It tastes good, too. You know, some people are not happy with the way you protect this old man who might take away their precious lands and houses. Dear sister, please. Oh, Nikos, forget it. We're here to talk business, and no one can hear us in here if we speak quietly. But before business, tell me, how is our granddaughter? She is with Lady Julia Felix again tonight. I hear that Lydia fairly lives there. Yes, she will learn a lot. Exactly, priestess, sister, Alethea. That is the point, I fear. So I have hoped. Old man, you are finally showing some good sense. She was getting old out there on your island, and she had to come in from that rock to get some city blood under her skin. Yes. And what's this about her marrying your friend here? She told me that I had to ask. Oh, I scrolled it to the wrong part. She told me that I had to ask you. But one of my servants told me you and Julia and Lydia and Pastor Timaeus had decided this question. And when I put that to her, Lydia refused to deny it. Julia told me that you would ask me, of course. Yes, sister. In fact, that is why I am here tonight, answering your call. I need to ask you to help and give your blessings. As priestess of the Holy Mother Isis. Excuse me, I have to type in that change. As priestess of the Holy Mother Isis. Oh my, and to think I had thought you were going to cut me out of the wedding? No. Oh, please, my love, don't. I am her grandmother, after all. Yes, and you were there when she was born, but I am legally her father. I know. But let us leave that for later. We must get to business. I'm afraid my reputation as leader of this temple requires me to ask you certain favors. You certain favors. My God, I'm rewriting this as I read it. All right, proceed. My dear old Nikos, how long have we known each other? Almost 60 years now? Yes, almost. My friend, brother, lover, you would not believe the begging prayers that come to me about you. Isis, tell him to approve our land. Isis, beg him to accept our payments. No one knows whether you really are friendly with the old Nero priest who claims Poppaea's villa or not. Then today we heard you have joined forces with a young ensign from Pompey at the naval base. Yes. Ah, Nikos, you are playing heavy and hard again, aren't you? Excuse me? You really are working for another emperor and balancing all his family, aren't you? I am afraid that is the truth. Well, at least this one is a little more reasonable, if I may use that word. Yes, advisedly. Amen. A fly! You know, my initials are D for Daniel, and T for Tijuana. How long has it been since we last kissed hello? Just last year, Alethea. No, I mean when we were still trying to live like husband and wife, in between your distant assignments to Germany, Britain, Greece, Egypt. It was a long time ago. And I have always been afraid that that little Boots Caligula got in between us. He did. But now I fear we will shock your new son, Timaeus. Yes, Holy Mother? Well, how odd. I suddenly realize I am like your new grandmother now that you are marrying my granddaughter. Yes, Mother. Well, I know in public you must call me Priestess of Isis and all that word, but here alone, Timaeus, please call me Alethea. Yes, thank you. But sister, you said we have to talk business. Yes, of course, but we have time, dearest Nico. I know you. Let me get to know my new son-in-law better, if you please. Timos, that is what your close family and friends call you, is it now? Yes, Alethea. Well, and when you feel close, or when we speak in private with your wife with us, then especially you may call me Thea. Thank you, Mother Alethea. Oh, so polite. Tell me, Praetor, the word I hear is you have very little family in the East. Your mother died when you were young. No brothers or sisters, only brothers and sisters. No brothers and sisters, only two women, my lady. They were killed in the wars when their city fell. Well, you know how those things go. Terrible sometimes what we do to each other, we humans. Especially you war-making men. Please, don't tell me about that. I hear myself, Mother, that you were very helpful when Lydia was born, and her mother took such a grievous turn. That is true, my son. We women sometimes suffer even in peaceful life, not just in war. Thank you for that, dear Mother. She is a beautiful one, yes, is she not? That she is. When did you first meet her? When I finally returned from the East 3 years ago. And you are how old now? 43. But you know that already. Yes, I do, but you understand I had to ask it because until now I only knew what people told me. How much better I should have the truth from your own mouth. Thank you. You are welcome, Timos, but tell me now, tell me about your mother and father and what your family was like when you were young. That will begin to help me understand what I may expect from you as my son, or rather grandson-in-law. Very good, my lady. Sorry. Oh, so formal again. Sorry. You know, of course, I already know about you as a magistrate here in Pompeii, but on a personal level, I only know you're an old friend of my dear brother, ex-husband, Nikos here, old ex-husband Nikos here, save. Oh, wait. You did know that he and I were married once, don't you? Yes, my lady. I have heard some such history. Did Nicodemus tell you, I hope? Yes, ma'am, he has told me. Uh-huh, still so formal. Sorry, Alethea. Better. And he said that is how we got our granddaughter after her mother died. Yes, I suppose. Yes, Alethea. Good. The truth, as it always is a bit more complicated. Since we both believe that it was Caligula who actually impregnated me with her life, as it were. Oh, dear. And her daughter, my granddaughter, your wife, my granddaughter, your wife, actually is his daughter, not her mother. Nikos? Dearest, I told him, much like you did, that it was complicated, difficult. But until now, you never spoke the truth to him. We never had the chance. Nicodemus, yes, Timus, you know you have always been like my father, so while this may sound extraordinarily unusual, but in a way, I am happier that this is the truth. He means if it is true that Caligula and not you are her grandfather. Yes, he does. A woman knows these things, Timos. Lydia's mother was not the daughter of Nicodemus. No, your mother-in-law, may she shine in heaven like Isis with Osiris, was my daughter, yes, and I gave birth to her all those years ago, 7 months after Caligula was killed. And he was the one man who put his seed into me that month when I conceived her 9 months before. Of that fact, I am absolutely certain. But her father? Yes, it was here in the temple. So we're at 13 minutes and 17 seconds. And you saw how, even though I had the text before me that I was reading, I rewrote it as I was reading it. And that for me is how the process often works. I'll work on a text and I'll read it to myself and change it while I'm reading it. And then back and forth. And the truth is, I'm not ready. I have so much more to learn. I have to read Homer, and all them damn Greeks, and the Romans, and the Bible, Old Testament especially. But until then, this was a piece of the story continuing to evolve. Goodbye.